Welcome to the next class. In today's class, we will see about Brayton cycle with some attachments. And in previous class, what we had seen was about Brayton cycle, its calculation for network output, its calculation for thermal efficiency, and then we went on finding out what is the optimum condition when we can get maximum network of the Brayton cycle. And now we are supposed to find out what is the effect of different attachments on the Brayton cycle. So first attachment is heat exchanger, next attachment is reheater, and then intercooler, and then we will see what is the mixed or combined effect of all these things. We should remember, in our earlier lecture we had discussed about heat exchanger. We know that from last derivation, efficiency of Brayton cycle depends upon pressure ratio. So if we increase the pressure ratio or operating pressure ratio of the cycle, efficiency of the cycle increases. Similarly, if we attach heat exchanger, attachment of heat exchanger also increases the efficiency of the cycle. We had also seen that heat exchanger attachment is not that good idea if we go for high pressure ratio, since there are losses with it. Attachment of reheater is more for getting more work output, and attachment of intercooler is to reduce the work input. So these three attachments have three different reasonings, and then we will see one attachment each. So Brayton cycle with heat exchanger. So let us see Brayton cycle with heat exchanger. Cycle with heat exchanger. So the attachment is this way. If we see, we first have compressor. We know that there is a compressor, so we will denote it as C. So air comes in the compressor and then it goes out from the compressor to the combustion chamber, but while going out it will pass through a heat exchanger, and then this is combustion chamber. Then air goes to the turbine, so this is turbine, and then turbine exhaust goes into the heat exchanger, where there is heat exchange between the air, which is actually going to the combustion chamber. So this is heat exchanger. So now, as our usual denotations, this is 1, this point is 2, then this point we will say it as, we will denote this point as, this point as 2, as it was denoted earlier. Then this point is 5 for us, since combustion exhaust is 3, turbine exhaust is 4, heat exchanger exhaust is 6. So process 1-2-2, compressor, compression, process 2-5 is heat addition in heat exchanger. Process 5-3 is heat addition in combustion chamber. Process 3-4 is expansion, and then we have 4-6, this is in heat loss in heat exchanger. Then obviously we will have 6-1, which is heat loss, but we are considering in general open cycle gas turbine power plant. But if it would have been closed cycle, then obviously we would have heat loss or pre-cooler. pre cooling. Now our job is to denote this cycle on the TS diagram. Suppose this is T axis, this is S axis. Now we have 1 to 2 is compression, then we have process 2 to 5 is heat addition in heat exchanger, but that is at constant pressure again. So 2 to 5 is constant pressure heat addition in the heat exchanger. Then we have 5 to 6 same pressure, or 5 to 3 it will continue with the same pressure. Then we have 3 to 4 and then we have 4 to 6. This is heat loss in heat exchanger, and then 6 to 1 is pre-cooler. So this is how our TS diagram would look like. Now if I draw PV diagram for the same cycle, then PV diagram would look like, we have P axis, we have specific volume as V axis, and 1 to 2 is isentropic compression. So 1 to 2 is isentropic compression. 2 to 3 is isobaric heat addition. So 2 to 3 in the heat exchanger. Then 2 to 5 is heat exchanger heat addition. 5 to 3 is heat addition in combustion chamber. Then 3 to we have 4 expansion in the turbine, and then we have 4 to 6 heat loss in heat exchanger, and 6 to 1 we have heat loss in pre-cooler. So these are the PV diagrams. Now we have to find out the network and efficiency formulation for the attachment with heat exchanger, Brayton cycle with heat exchanger. So first, the process 1 to 2 we will have same. We will have 1 to 2 W1 to 2 is unaltered. So W1 to 2 is absolute value is Cp into T2 minus T1. Again, this is for compressor work input. Similarly, W3-4 which is Cp into T3 minus T4 which is turbine work, this is also unaltered. So if we see W net which is WT minus WC is unaltered, and that is Cp into T3 minus T4 minus Cp into T2 minus T1. So this formula is unaltered with the attachment of heat exchanger. But what is changed then? The change thing is Q in, which is amount of heat added into the system. In olden case, without heat exchanger, heat addition was Cp into T3 minus T2. That is from external source. But now we have heat addition from external source by combustion is only Cp into T3 minus T5. So this is the only amount of heat added into the process of heat transfer in combustion chamber. So this is how it is going to be lessened by an amount which is Cp into T5 minus T2. So we will have efficiency will be higher, since for efficiency formula we have W net upon Q in, but formula for W net is not changed, but formula for Q in shows decrement in Q in. So efficiency of the cycle would increase. But then there are some issues which we should remember. Issue 1, when can we add heat exchanger? When we had seen that attachment of heat exchanger is considered only for low pressure ratio gas turbines. But when? For this van, basic requirement is you should have T4 should be greater than T2. Then only we can add the attachment for heat exchanger. If T4 is greater than T2, then heat exchange is not possible to the air which is going to the combustion chamber. It is also clear from this TS diagram. So for that we need T2 to be lesser than T4 or T4 to be greater than T2. Then what we next have to see is what is the heat transfer in heat exchanger. Heat transfer in heat exchanger. There are two elements in the heat exchanger. One is air in the process 2 to 5. So there is Q25 and that has to be equal to Q46. Since this is heat loss, rather this is heat gain by the air which is going to the combustion chamber, and this is heat loss by the gas which is going out from the turbine exhaust. So what is Q225? It is Cp into T5 minus T2, and this is equal to Cp into T4 minus T6. So this is equal, but Cp we are considering calorically perfect gas, so Cp is same. So we practically get T5 minus T2 is equal to T4 minus T6. This is what we are getting. Next thing what we have to see is there is a concept called as effectiveness of heat exchanger. Effectiveness of heat exchanger. And effectiveness of heat exchanger is actual heat transfer by maximum possible heat transfer. And what is actual heat transfer? Actual heat transfer is what we know. It is from last slide. What is actual heat transfer? Cp into T5 minus T2 is actual heat transfer, or Cp into T4 minus T6 is also actual heat transfer. So actual heat transfer is Cp into T5 minus T2. But what is maximum possible heat transfer? Maximum possible heat transfer is T4 minus T2. So basically this is the maximum temperature at the heat exchanger divided by minimum temperature in the heat exchanger. So this is the maximum or big temperature difference in the heat exchanger. So Cp into T4 minus T2. So this gives us the formula for effectiveness of heat exchanger. So effectiveness of heat exchanger practically for us is by cancelling Cp we get T5 minus T2 divided by T4 minus T2. Now we are going to consider the cases where we will have ideal assumption for the heat exchanger. So let us consider the heat exchanger to be ideal. So heat exchanger will have efficiency which is 100% or effectiveness to be 1. So let us consider that this to be 1. Once this is 1, it leads to T5 minus T2 is equal to T4 minus T2, and then this leads to T5 is equal to T4. This is one outcome. But effectiveness can also be written as, for the heat exchanger, instead of T5 minus T2, it is also is equal to T4 minus T6 divided by T4 minus T2. This is also heat transfer in the heat exchanger. We have seen it in the last slide. Heat transfer is either Cp into T5 minus T2 or Cp into T4 minus T6. This is heat gain by the air from the exhaust, and this is heat loss by the exhaust to the air. So this is actual heat transfer. Both are, we can say here, as actual heat transfer. So what we will have here is also for ideal case it is 1, and then this would lead to T4 minus T6 is equal to T4 minus T2. So we will have T6 is equal to T2 for ideal case. So what is going to happen in ideal case? So we will go back and we will see what is going to happen in ideal case. In the ideal case, we can clearly see that there are few things which will be like this. In case we have ideal case leads to T5 is equal to T4 and T6 is equal to T2. So what we are having is T5 is equal to T4 and T6 is equal to T2. So temperature is same. So this is how ideal heat exchanger would operate. So we have to keep this point in mind. So this, keeping this point in mind, we have to modify our formula for W net, and we have to modify our formula for efficiency of heat exchanger. So let us write down the formula for network W net. What we wrote is Cp into T3 minus T4 minus Cp into T2 minus T1. There is no alteration in it, but Q in is equal to Cp into T3 minus T5. But what is T5? We can see this Cp in T5, T3 minus T5. So what is T5? We have seen T5 is equal to T4. So Cp into T3 minus T4. So now let us define the efficiency, thermal efficiency with heat exchanger, and then it is W net upon Q in. So it is Cp into T3 minus T4 minus Cp into T2 minus T1 divided by Cp into T3 minus T4. So this would lead to 1 minus Cp into T2 minus T1 in divided by Cp into T3 minus T4. Okay, so thermal efficiency of heat exchanger is equal to 1 minus Cp, Cp cancels out, we have T2 minus T1 divided by T3 minus T4. So we know formulas for T2 and T4, we can use those formulas, and as per those formulas, 1 minus T1 into Rp bracket raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma minus T1 divided by T3 minus T3 divided by Rp bracket raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma. So this is equal to 1 minus, we can take T1 common, so T1, we can take T3 common, so T3. So this in the bracket Rp bracket raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma minus 1 divided by Rp bracket raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma minus 1, but then this Rp will go in the top, and then we will get Rp into bracket raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma. So thermal efficiency is equal to 1 minus Rp bracket raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma divided by beta, where we know Rp is equal to P2 by P1 or Rp is equal to P3 by P4 and beta is equal to T3 by T1 or T max by T min. Similarly, Rp is equal to P max by P min. So, this formula is for heat exchanger attachment for the Brayton cycle based power plant, but constraint it heat exchanger has effectiveness 100%, or in case heat exchanger effectiveness, this formula is for heat exchanger effectiveness is equal to 1. So, this is the constraint. Having said this, now if we are given with an example, or if we have to design a thermal power plant where we are supposed to use the heat exchanger, then we can do all the calculations and find out W net and efficiency effect, thermal efficiency of the power plant. Having done with the heat exchanger, we will see the next attachment as reheater. Our next attachment is reheater, Brayton cycle based power plant with reheater. As I said earlier, use of reheater is more for increasing the power output of the Brayton cycle based power plant. So, here as well we will have compressor, air will come into the compressor. So, this is C. From the compressor it will go to the combustion chamber, so it is CC, then it goes to a turbine and we call it as high pressure turbine. So, initially air would go to high pressure turbine. High pressure turbine exhaust is connected to a reheater. So, here is the concept of reheater. Then from reheater it goes to the low pressure turbine. So, this is low pressure turbine and then air is exhausted. So, this is how we will have Brayton cycle based power plant for the attachment with reheater. So, here we will again number 1, we will number it as 2, we will number it as 3, we will number it as 4, 5 and 6. So, the process 1 to 2 is compression, process 2 to 3 is heat addition in combustion chamber, then process 3 to 4 is expansion in high pressure turbine, then process 4 to 5 is heat addition in reheater, and then process 5 to 6 for open cycle power plant is expansion in low pressure turbine, but thermodynamically we will have process 6 to 1 in the precooler. So, now we have to draw thermodynamic cycle for this reheater attachment. Again we will draw TS diagram. So, this is T axis, this is S axis. So, process 1 to 2, process 1 to 2 is isentropic compression. Okay, so then process 2 to 3 is isobaric heat addition. So this is 3. 3 to 4 isentropic expansion. So this is 4. Then 4 to 5 is isobaric heat addition. So this is 5. 5 to 6 is isentropic expansion. So this is 6. 6 to 1 is precooler. So here 1 to 2 is isobaric, 2 to 3 is 1 to 2 is isentropic, 2 to 3 is isobaric, 3 to 4 is isentropic, 4 to 5 is isobaric, 5 to 6 is isentropic, 6 to 1 is again isobaric. So this is TS diagram for Brayton cycle with reactor attachment, and this is the reactor. Now we can draw PV diagram for the same attachment. So this is P, this is specific volume V. In the PV diagram, first we have 1 to 2 as isentropic compression, 2 to 3 is constant pressure heat addition, 3 to 4 is isentropic expansion, 4 to 5 is constant pressure heat addition, 5 to 6 is isentropic expansion, and 6 to 1 we have isobaric heat rejection. So this is Brayton cycle based power plant thermodynamic cycle for reheater array. Now we have to again do the same calculation for W net and Q in, and so we have to find out what is the thermal efficiency. We have to keep one point in mind, that we have to use same formulas what we used to use for calculation of all corner quantities. So if we know 3, T3 and P3, then we should be able to find out P4 and T4 from isentropic relations. Similarly, if we know everything at 4, then we can find out everything other thing at 5. However, there are certain constraints which would be known to us later on. In this phase, our W, now we will have WC which is equal to W12, and that is equal to Cp into T2 minus T1. This is unaltered, but WT is changed. Now we have not just WT, we have W high pressure turbine, and that is W34, that is Cp into T3 minus T4, and then we have W low pressure turbine, that is W56, that is Cp into T5 minus T6. So we have total turbine work, WT is equal to W34 plus W56. So we have Cp into T3 minus T4 plus Cp into T5 minus T6. Parallelly, we have Q in, and Q in is equal to, there are two heat addition processes. One is Q23 plus Q45. So we have Cp into T3 minus T2 plus Cp into T5 minus T4. So these two formulas are changed. So efficiency with thermal efficiency of Brayton cycle based power plant with reheater arrangement is changed, and now we have W net upon Q in, and W net is equal to WT minus WC divided by Q in. So WT can be found out from here, WC can be found out from here, Q in found can be found out from here, and then we can find out thermal efficiency of the Brayton cycle based power plant. But for the reheater arrangement, we have to know one thing. Rather, there are two things. First thing, generally, whenever we are using Brayton cycle waste power plant with reheater arrangement, then we should know one thing, that we generally get T3 is equal to T5 is equal to Tmax. These two temperatures are same. These two temperatures are same. So having same temperatures, we can have this is T max and this is T min. There is one more point to be noted, that what is P4? What is the value of P4? Means we should ask ourselves a question, that when we should stop expanding the gas into the low pressure or rather high pressure turbine. At what condition it should enter into the reheater? So what is the pressure of reheater? So P4 is reheater pressure. What is that? So what is reheater pressure? So this is a question, and we will do a derivation for this question, that how to find out what is the optimum condition for reheater so that we can get a given objective to be achieved. So what is our objective in case of reheater based attachment? Our objective is that there is certain amount of oxygen remained into the air which is uncombusted. So for it has not taken part in the combustion, so we have to burn that, and by burning that we are going to get more work output. So getting more work output is our basic objective function over here. So for that we have to find out what is the P4, what is the condition in, or what is the pressure of reheater such that it would lead us to maximum net work. So let us define this. So what our objective over here is to find out what is the reheater pressure which would lead to maximum net work. So let us work out what is W net. W net for us is W high pressure turbine plus W low pressure turbine minus W compressor. So W net, it is equal to Cp. What is high pressure turbine work? It is T3 minus T4. We should remember it here. T3 minus T4, T5 minus T6, and T2 minus T1. T3 minus T4 plus Cp into T5 minus T6 is low pressure turbine work, and then we have compressor work is Cp into T2 minus T1. Now, having said this, we can take Cp common and write down T3 minus T4 plus T5 minus T6 minus T2 plus T1. Now, there is one more thing. We will put here a constraint which says that T3 is equal to T5, or what we will write our constraint as T3 is equal to T5 is equal to Tmax, and we will also say the constraint 1, constraint 2, we have Tmax upon Tmin which is beta, and then that is constant. So our objective is to find out what is the W net max for these two constraints. If T3 is equal to T5 is equal to T max, and T max upon T min, which is beta, is equal to constant. So for these two constraints, we will carry forward our derivation, and as per that, we have W net is equal to Cp, then T3 minus T4, then we have T5, but T5 is equal to T3 minus T6 minus T2 plus T1. So W net is equal to Cp into twice T3 minus T4 minus T6 minus T2 plus T1. But we again know that conditions at the inlet are known. We know that conditions at the inlet are known. So for that all fact, we have T1 is known. Similarly, Cp is known. So we will continue this derivation, and in that now we can get W net is equal to Cp into T1 divided by 2 into T3 by T1 minus T4 by T1 minus T6 by T1 minus T2 by T1 plus 1. So W net is equal to Cp T1. So we can write it as 2 into beta. T3 by T1 is beta, and similarly T5 by T1 is also beta, minus we can see here T4 by T3 into T3 by T1. So we have divided and multiplied by T3. Why did we do so? Since we can see 4 and 3 are on isentropic line, so there is a relation which is known between temperature at 4 and temperature at 3, and further by doing so we got introduced with beta. So beta is known, which is T3 by T1, and then this relation would also be known. Similarly, T6 is here, so we can replace it, we can replace it and say that this is basically T6 divided by T5 into T5 divided by T1. But what is T5? T5 is basically T3. What is T5? T5 is basically T3, so my plus 1. So W net is equal to Cp T1 twice beta minus T4 by T3. What is T4 by T3? 1 upon Rp bracket raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma into beta. Okay, so minus T6 by T3, which is T6 by basically T5. So T6 by T5, T6 by T5 is also same way. We can see it as T6 by T5 is also 1 upon Rp bracket raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma into beta plus 1. So we get this formulation for the W net. Now we have to do few things about evaluation of this formula. So let us work out. Okay, so what we can do here, that we can write W net is equal to Cp T1 is equal to into 2 into beta. We can take this one closure, 2 into beta plus 1 minus T4 divided by T3. We are going to rearrange this term, which is T4 by T1, as T4 divided by T3 into T3 divided by T1 minus. Similarly, we can do it for 6. T4 by T3 is for high pressure turbine, and T6 by T5 is for low pressure turbine. So we can do it for here also, which is T6 by T5 into T5 by T1 minus T2 by T1 plus, so this plus 1 is accounted, so we will have bracket complete. So W net practically would be Cp T1 into twice beta plus 1 minus T4 by T3 into beta, T3 by T1 is beta, minus T6 by T5. What is T5? T5 is T3 by T1 minus T2 by T1. So W net is equal to Cp T1 in the bracket 2 beta plus 1 minus T4 by T3 into beta minus T6 by T5 into beta minus T2 by T1. This is the derivation for W net. But we did not achieve our objective yet. We have to continue. So let us continue. We will take this W net here. So W net is basically equal to Cp T1 into twice beta plus 1 minus T4 by T3 into beta minus T6 by T5 into beta minus T2 by T1 and then bracket complete. So we have 1, 2, 3 and 4 terms and then we have 1, 2, 3 and 4 terms, correct. So here let us start seeing, let us redraw the diagram, reconsider the diagram, and here let us see that this is for compressor, this is T2 by T1. For high pressure turbine, this is T3 by T4. And for low pressure turbine, this is T5 by T6. So let us write this. So let T be the temperature ratio which is for compressor. Let T1 be the temperature ratio for high pressure turbine. Let T2 be the temperature ratio for low pressure turbine. What we are going to achieve with this? We are going to achieve it this way. So W net formula, we can directly replace it by this. Here what we will have is this way. Basically we know Rp, temperature T2 by T1 is equal to Rp bracket raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma. Similarly, we know T3 by T4 is P3 by P4 bracket raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma. Let us say that P3 by P4 is Rp1, then that is equal to bracket raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma. Then we have T5 by T6 is equal to P5 by P6 bracket raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma. Let us say P5 by P6 as Rp2 bracket raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma. So T is equal to, from this, T is equal to Rp raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma. So from here T1 is equal to Rp1 bracket raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma. From here we have T2 is equal to Rp2 bracket raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma. But what is Rp? Rp is equal to P2 by P1. What is Rp1 we wrote? Rp1 is P3 by P4. What is Rp2 we wrote? We wrote it as P5 by P6. Then what is Rp1 into Rp2? It is P3 by P4 into P5 by P6. But if we go back and see the diagram, then P4 is equal to P5. This we should remember. So if P4 is equal to P5, this will cancel out. We will get it as P3 divided by P6. But what is P3? What is P3? P3 is equal to P2. P6 is equal to P1. So P3 is equal to P2. P6 is equal to P1. So this is RP. So we get RP is equal to RP1 into RP2. So if we put this in the formulations for temperature over here in this row, we will get T is equal to T1 into T2. We can prove this. There is no problem. RP, we can do this bracket raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma, then bracket raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma, bracket raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma. Then we can get T is equal to T1 into T2. So this is how we can use this. That is why W net is equal to Cp T1 twice beta plus 1 minus T3 by T4 by T3, and T4 by T3 is 1 upon T1 for us, into beta minus T6 by T5. This is 1 upon T2 for us, into beta minus T. But we can consider that we are working with, we'll assume one more thing over here, that we are working along with other constraints, as for constraints, total number of constraints, as what we said, beta constant, Cp T1 known. Similarly, Rp or T is known. So if this constraint is there, then T is a constant for this derivation. And then for this case, we can get W net is equal to Cp T1 twice beta plus 1 minus 1 upon T1 into beta. We can replace this T2 by this expression, which is T2 is equal to 1 upon T by T1 into beta minus T. So W net is equal to Cp T1 twice beta plus 1 minus beta upon T1 minus T1 beta upon T minus T. So this expression we have to remember. We have to keep it forward, and then we can differentiate this W net with respect to T1. So from this expression, W net is equal to Cp T1 into twice beta plus 1 minus beta T1 minus, we have beta T1 upon T minus T. Then for getting maximum W net, let us differentiate this with respect to T1 and then equate it to 0, so that we can get W net maximum. W net maximum. So there are few terms. If we are going to equate it to 0, Cp T1 being constant, it will go beta is a constant, T is a constant. So this term in the bracket would have 0 derivative. This term will also have 0 derivative. So practically we have only 2 terms to get differentiated. So we will have minus beta into plus beta upon t1 square plus beta upon t1 square. This is differentiation of first term. Minus beta t is equal to 0. So beta beta would cancel out. So we get t1 is equal to square root of t. T1 is equal to square root of t. But what we know? We know t1 into t2 is equal to t. So it leads to t2 is also equal to square root of c. So it leads to t1 equal to t2 equal to square root of t. So this is the constraint for which we can get W net maximum. So W net max is equal to Cp T1 twice beta plus 1 minus beta divided by square root of T minus beta divided by again square root of T minus T. So this is the expression for maximum W net. So this is how we can arrive at the constraint for the reheater based Brayton cycle power plant where we can get maximum W net. So the arrangement for intercooler and rest of the thing we will see in the next class.